if I'm in the zone, baby. Am I in the zone? I had something prepared to say after this, but then I forgot it. Why am I laughing? Herbs like mint, basil, some more fresh I'm not to be an alcoholic when it's so good. Before we start making the highballs, you're gonna need the raspberry gin. So to see how to make it, just check out our video, which will be somewhere over here. Three easy gin infusions. One of those infusions is the raspberry gin. First of all, let me explain what a highball is. It's a drink that you build straight into the glass and you fill up with some type of a filler. We have different types today. We have some spicy ginger, tonic water, and grapefruit lemonade. I also love to garnish my drinks. You know, we say that the eye eats first, or drinks first in this case. So I have prepared some fresh herbs like mint, basil, also some more raspberries for the garnish, and fresh limes, which we are going to squeeze straight into our glasses. Let's start off with a raspberry grapefruit highball. To do this, we're gonna need a highball glass or a Collins glass or some glass which you think will fit enough, like the whole drink will fit inside. So to start, I'm gonna squeeze half of a fresh lime, which is going to balance out the sweetness of the grapefruit lemonade. It's gonna add a nice sour and fresh taste to it. Now I'm going to measure 50 mils, or around 1.5 ounces of raspberry gin. I suggest that you fill up the glass with as much ice as possible. So I'm gonna fill up the whole glass. It's gonna keep my drink longer alive. So basically it's gonna stay up colder for a longer period of time, and the dilution process is gonna happen slower. And in this way, it's easier to measure my grapefruit lemonade without, you know, adding too much of it. I would suggest around double the amount of the gin that you add. So I have 50 mils. So I think that 100, 120 mils of grapefruit lemonade is gonna be enough. Yes, and now I'm gonna pour it gently into my drink. This, and then using a spoon, I'm gonna gently stir it just to mix up everything. Maybe give it a taste. Wow. And now, as for the garnish, you can use any fresh herbs that you have and think that you fit. Even fresh thyme will work. I'm gonna actually go for basil. I think the basil and grapefruit match pretty well together. Like this. You know, place it on top, not inside the drink, so that when your guest or you have a sip, you get the nice fresh aroma from the basil. And why not some fresh raspberries? I mean, we have raspberry gin in there. And there we have it, a beautiful and I hope delicious raspberry grapefruit Collins. Let's give it a taste. Perfect. Slight bitterness from the grapefruit, freshness from the lime, we get the basil in the nose, and of course the fruity flavor of the gin. That's great for summer, for spring, even for any time of the year. It's great. Cheers. The second highball I really enjoy is the raspberry gin and tonic. For this, again, I'm gonna pick a tall glass, like this one, and start off by squeezing half of this lime straight in there. And now measure 50 mils, or how much you like, in your glass. Perfect. And now fill up the glass once again with as much ice as possible. And now time to add our tonic water straight to our Collins glass. All right, the drink is built. Now time to give it a small slight stir, just to mix up everything again. Mm. And as for the garnish, let's go for raspberries one more time. Not only it looks great, but it also, it's like a nice edible garnish that you can treat your guests with, or yourself, of course. And let's go for mint. We'll slap it just to release more of the essential oils, more of that fresh minty aroma. Like this. Again, I'm gonna place it on top, not inside the drink. And there you have it, a raspberry gin and tonic. Cheers. The third highball I would like to show you is the raspberry and ginger Collins. This time we're gonna use spicy ginger as our filler. And once again, highball glass, half of lime squeezed straight into the glass. 50 mils of raspberry gin. A bit more. And again, fill up the glass with ice. And we're gonna use spicy ginger now. And now let's garnish it again with raspberries. What a surprise. Sec, like this, and let's go for basil this time again, because why not, man, why not, it smells nice. Okay, raspberry and ginger Collins. Ooh, this one is spicy, of course, because of the ginger. If you know the Moscow Mule and like it, then you're definitely gonna love this one. Cheers! Those were the drinks I really wanted to show you. I really hope that you like the video and make those drinks. And if you do so, make sure to subscribe, as you don't want to miss our next episodes. Cheers and have a nice sip!